Hey, what's up, guys? It's oNightPineberries, and I'm back with some more Dungeon Defenders 2. So, thanks for all the suggestions, tips, and comments, guys. I really do appreciate them. And, so today's episode is one of the most requested things I do right now, is start a new character. That is the Apprentice, the mighty enchanter, Shiroe. So I'm going to be playing the Apprentice now. His stats overall are fairly similar to all the other characters because there's no difference yet. But there's really cool stuff that he has, notably is the Fire Fiend. And the most important tower that he has is the Frostbite Tower, which we'll be getting soon. Before I begin, there's one thing that I've been complaining about and why people are like, oh, why are you complaining about this so much, oNightPineberries? You know, just it's you know, the game is difficult for a reason. You know, I like the difficulty is nice. Well, the fact is that I have to go back to train. If I want to train a new character, I have to go back from the very beginning of the game and I have to slowly grind my way up. And it takes like 4 to 5 maps, or like 2 to 3 maps to level up every time. So I have to do that every single time. I'm like, I don't know. It's very time consuming where I can just play a couple maps and then get my lowest character up to speed so I can use them in the higher tier gameplay, which is what I really need, is pretty much the Apprentice's, the Frostbite Towers, because they improved it dramatically, and private game is not, it's frozen. What has happened? No, please don't do this to me. No, not again. All right, guys, I am back. I apologize for that little hiccup. I don't know what the cause is. It just happens. I don't know how to, like, if it's, I know it's a bug, but I don't know how to reproduce it because it happens extremely randomly. Let me check the ambulance really fast. Not that good. So yeah, it happens very randomly, so I can't really do much about it. So, the Apprentice is a ranged melee or ranged magic class, so it's pretty interesting if you're into that mage class style. He has two support towers? So he has one support tower, and then, wait, what's this? No, he has two support towers and two damage dealing towers. His first support tower is the barricade, which we get at level 3. I believe level 7 is the Frostbite Tower, I believe that's what it's called. Yeah, the Frostbite Tower. And then finally is the Earth Shatterer Tower, which is, I'm pretty positive this is the most, or the highest DPS tower in the game as of now. But it's not very good unless you have really good stats, which is the most unfortunate part. So as you can see, my Huntress is level 3. There's level scaling, so that's nice. That is actually very nice. Makes the game much more replayable. I never said that like having to go back to the lower levels is a bad thing. I just think it's just annoying. Like, it's good for when you're playing with friends, like when they're just starting out, but it's annoying for people who play solo, especially like me, and I don't play with other people because I have no friends. But I just find it frustrating because we have to do this, like, this unnecessary grind over and over for every single character, and it's just very time consuming, and it's like for a casual gamer who doesn't have that much time and wants to get all his characters to high tier, like the end game, it takes weeks, you know? It's not very time friendly, but anyways, we do have like overpowered characters now, so it's fine. If you guys notice, every time I attack a mob with my basic A, my left click and my right click, it leaves like a little sigil, like a mark on said character. Ooh, I got a shield. I'll show you again once that happens. What is this shield? It's pretty bad. Rise, my blaze, balloons of destruction. Rise. So I'll show you right now. Once they come. Oh no, it's this lane. I don't want to waste it just yet. But I can just shoot it. Oh, it didn't. Okay, never mind. Oh, new staff. Defense speed. Nice damage. Nice sword. Nice. But yeah, wow, look at that. Look at this staff. It's like, what is that? It's just like little orbs. It's like molecules floating around my orb. But anyways, okay. Can't really show a good example because they're all melting too quickly. Level 2! Alright, so we got... Oh, level 2, it's not level 3. Okay, so level 2, we get the Arcane Barrier. It's actually fantastic. I'll read the description to you, but all I know is it's like the barricade, the spike blockade, but it does damage over time. blocks enemies after losing 25% of its max health, it self-destructs. Dealing magical damage, regenerates after a delay, knocking enemies backwards, draw extra attention from enemies. So it's pretty much, essentially it's the same thing as the whatchamacallit, I forgot his name, the spike blockade. But this one does a little bit more damage, and it knocks back mobs, especially ogres. And you'll see why it becomes really crucial to have in the late game. They become very annoying. Oh, I should be doing this instead. Yeah, that makes more sense. That's not in a good spot. 8A this. A. I keep on saying A because I'm so into Smash. Smashing, baby. I've been playing so much Super Smash Brothers lately. Not really, that's a lie. Yeah, it's literally been my entire week. Let's do this. This. That. And with the remaining mana, we're gonna repair everything. Wow, that the Blaze Bloom in the far left lane just completely did all the work on its own. That's fantastic. Alright, let's switch back to Shiroe. And before I forget, let's go into the spec sheet. So, I don't know if I did this for the other characters, but he has a quite an interesting set. So he's reduced cooldown for Tornado and Arcane Valley, which is his two main DPS abilities, which are actually very strong and really great for synergy-style towers, especially the Tornado. Okay, excuse me, sorry. So here's Blockade Boom. 0% of the damage taken by Arcane Barrier is returned in its next explosion. So we can make Arcane Barriers do a lot more damage, which is pretty cool. We have double fireball! 0% chance for Flame Burst Tower to shoot a second fireball that does 70% damage. So it's pretty much dealing a little bit more AoE. Originally, the Flame Burst Tower used to ricochet, but they changed it to be like more like the Fireball Tower in Dungeon Defenders 1. We have Mage Spec, increases your mana regeneration by per second by 0 or X. I should say X, but not tower mana, it's your hero mana. So please get that, keep that in mind. It doesn't give you tower mana, which is, if it did, that would be extremely overpowered. We have freeze, which is the main reason why I'm getting this. It is X percent chance to for the Frostbite Tower to freeze its target at the end of its channel for 3 seconds. This is extremely crucial when you're fighting against ogres, because this can save your life. We also have earthy knockup, X percent chance for each Earth Shatterer Tower to attack, each Earth Shatterer Tower attack to knock enemies into the air. Tongue twisters. But yeah, pretty much it's just a knock up. It's really good synergisms with the Monk's Dragon Tower, the Sky Attack, Sky Guard Tower, or whatever it's called. It's really fantastic with that combo. But yeah, I heard they recently fixed the Sky Guard Tower, whatever the Monk Anti-Air Tower is called. Previously, it was just doing damage haphazardly to anything and everything. But now they changed it so it does damage to the closest targets first, and then the farthest targets, which is a nice fix. Let's just equip all items for now. But yeah, I can't really show you the marking. I'll get close. So if you look, do you see that weird thing? Oh no, they're all gonna die. Balls. Well, Blaze Balloon Tower's OP. I really don't care. I'm just trying to level them up. I'll eventually show you. But anyways, these marks are for Arcane Valley. Okay, there's a crike ton. It's unfortunately you have to do like one at a time. I'm missing all of them. So we have like that, and it hits those targets that were linked. I believe the max is 6, but that was only from the previous game or previous patches. I could be wrong. I definitely need to read the description again. But yeah, there's a noticeable difference in tower mana that's dropping. Notable difference. I can't. Let's upgrade that. Let's get the mana. And then from here, we're pretty much solid. We just have to upgrade the closest Blaze Balloon Towers. And of course, if you guys are just playing with they also removed a lot of the bonuses from the feats. Those things that I just got, Eventer. I believe they removed one of the killing ones because there was a recent exploit on getting like power leveling exploit. And I even said it. I think I did. Maybe I said it in my head, but I even like mentioned it kind of that people could abuse that because it's really crazy how fast I got EXP. Yeah, it's real thing. So we got mana, or the ability power one, which is nice, especially because we have this. But anyways, like I was saying, if you're playing just an apprentice first, it's gonna be hella difficult, because the flame burst towers aren't that strong early game. They become much bulkier and much stronger late game, but the early game, the first initial levels is very difficult. So I recommend just stacking 6 fire flame burst towers in the front, and as soon as you get your barricades, you place 2 barricades and you should be set. But other than that, I can't be bothered to show you guys because I really dislike the flame burst and the arcane barrier. I'm a big fan of the frostbite tower and the earth shatterer tower. So that's the main reason why I'm building an apprentice, because his utility is just too fantastic. And especially because the ogres, the cyclopses, they take reduced damage from physical attacks, but they take the max, and it's like super effective from magical attacks. So it's pretty much what this class is all about. But yeah, as you can see, the apprentice is very strong with his abilities. So keep that in mind. If you want to play a really good DPS character, I definitely recommend the mage if you don't like the physical DPS of a Huntress. But she does have a lot of magic defense or magic damage thanks to her Phoenix Fire, Hawk Fire, Destruction, AoE, God, Mother Effing Flame Shot, whatever it's called. That's really strong, but the charge up time is so unforgiving. You can die from it because the ogres can one shot anything and everything. So it's really annoying because that charge time, but it is very powerful. So that's, you know, I guess it evens out in some form. But I will show you the might, the flame burst towers. So I'm gonna place 2 in each lane. I don't think they'll survive for very long. Mainly because, not the towers, but the mobs itself, because the blaze bloom towers are just ripping everything. But yeah, the range is similar to that of the cannonball tower. However, the fireball towers, the flame burst towers, have a little bit higher arc, if I believe correctly. The attacking arc, I believe it's a little bit higher, or it could be the same, but it's still quite fantastic. Level 1, it does 57 DPS or 133 attack damage. If you level upgrade it once, it does 90 DPS or 199 damage per shot. So it's pretty nice indeed. But yeah, if I had to choose between the two, I would definitely choose the cannonball tower, just because I am a big squire fan. Squires for days, son. So let's mark you. Hot. I can't really test because maybe someday in the future, in a couple maps from now, when the maps get really hectic, I'm pretty sure we can try marking everything. I need a shoot. My lasers zooming out. Oh god, it can zoom very far out. Where is everything? What? What is this long timer? Yeah, okay, I gotta see if this still does AoE damage. Nope. Just does a lot of damage though. But yeah, the animation for the fireball towers or the flame burst towers, they look really nice. I really do like them. Let's see. Oh man, they all just melted. That's not fair. Can't really test it out. Ooh, money bags. Can't really test it out because we're too strong. Upgrade! But yeah, in the span of this, we could have gone to, like, my complaint is, I'm already level 3, yeah, but my complaint is I can be already level 10 by now in the span of the time. So I have to grind slowly but surely. That's just one of my complaints as a solo grinder. Cause it's so easy, it's just so boring. And I believe these guys are magic resistant. I believe they are. But in this game, it's usually the magic damage is usually superior to everything. I don't know why that is. It's in a lot of games lately. Magic damage is the superior choice. If you're gonna choose between physical and magic, magic is usually the best thing to do. Let's repair. But I could be wrong. It's just my opinion. That's what I feel. That's what I think. Let's upgrade that. Pair you. Pair that. It's already paired. Let's hit G. We'll be level 4 by the end of this, and then we can get to the next tier. Hopefully we can jump and we can like skip one tier. That would be really nice if we can skip a tier. But I don't think that's going to happen. But yeah, it's Oh, they stay on fire. Oh no, is that the... Yeah, I think that's the blaze balloon. Yeah. Let's see. They die in one hit. Never mind. I'm trying to see if they stay combusted. Combusted? They stay aflame. But this is definitely from the flame or the blaze balloon towers. So that's 5 or 4. So I know we for sure we can get 4. Let's see if we can get 5. Okay, 5 is done. Oh wow, we get an orc. I just noticed all the big guys are resistant to physical damage. That's weird. Oh, that does actually. That's not weird. That makes sense because they're bulky. So like you would cut their skin, but their skin is really, they have thick skin. Oh god. Is this 5 again? Yeah, it is. Oh no, did I one-shot one? Damn it. But yeah, as you can tell, that's a lot of fun. I did enjoy in the initial phase where I just ran around. Ooh, there's many, many to shoot. As you can see, the range is very far. That's another thing I should and could test out is the range. And I got to level 4. Fantastic. I was hoping to get at least level 5 so we can skip the 3-5 tier. I think it's 3-5. But yellow. Nope, green. Son of a bitch. I haven't gotten a blue yet. It's always been green. Piggies. Oh, we got a water blade of justice water. Let's pick up all the coins here. Don't forget to loot everything. There's no proof that... is there proof? I don't think anyone has made a document on if you can just leave everything. Like, especially coins. We got a really nice pole arm. 30% Interesting. That is just like utterly fantastic for monks, because he has the lightning towers or the lightning auras. So it's just you don't even need the geyser traps. You do all the damage on your own. Fantastic. But yeah, how come it doesn't show defense stats anymore? That's very bizarre. But as you can see, that was episode 9000. I'm gonna show you the fireball towers really quick. And then I'll show you... Oh, did not mean to do that. Come on, buddy. Hoorah! Alright, and then I'll show you quickly. Switch over to Leafa. And then we'll upgrade you, this, and that. So, look how fantastic those look. Oh god. I did like how the monk or the apprentice towers did look. They look very ethereal. No, arcane. Arcanic. But yeah, as you can tell, it's a little babby dragon. Like a little, it's growing up, and then this one's just like, I'm going to murder you, burn you to a crisp. And I will enjoy it. Oh, fantastic. I do like how they are floating on like a little ball of fire. It's fantastic. So the barrier itself looks very nice. But I don't know. I just think this, in my opinion, like this little, like that fire flame that's coming out of it, I think it looks very like, I don't know, very cheap. I don't know. Weak. I don't know. I don't know how to explain it, but it looks very like boring. I wish it was a little bit more flashy. Whoops, I did not mean to do that. But anyways, guys, let's leave with these guys on, because the last tier, oh, look how fantastic these look. But I do believe this is the last visual upgrade, which is on level 3. Are you 3 or are you 4? You're 3. Yeah, you're 3. So I think this is the last visual upgrade. I could be wrong. There could be the star, but from my memory, there's nothing after this, so... Again, I could be wrong. They could have changed it. We're just not there yet. So, Anyways, I'll check the thing before we leave, before we end the episode. Must check. Always check. Each map takes about 20 minutes, so always check. So we got Guardian's Powerful Glove. Whole defense speed increases defense defense interaction radius. What does that mean? We'll buy it anyways. Nope. I'm gonna save my monies. Okay. When damage is dealt, you deal 12.09 damage back. I will take it. Cause I'm a rich son of a. No, it's really nice for stats though. So this has decent stats. This also has decent stats. 30% chance of ballista. Not that great. None of these are too good. We do have this. No, where's you? Yeah, we got this, so that's a plus. But other than that, I'm gonna sell all the gear that we have. Has anyone else noticed that it looks like there's getting more and more detail on like this area every time we play? I just feel like every time I play, just more and more detail, more and more detail. I don't see any like Huntress gear. I see, so there's the Apprentice staff. There's the sword for the squire. There's a Sai. So there's some arrows. What about monk gear? Do you guys spy any monk gear? Doesn't look like there's any monk gear. That could be a monk thing, I guess. Squires and apprentices get all the love. Mainly the squire. Squire gets all the love, but the apprentice gets that. That's about it. Oh no, there's a staff right here. I lied. Okay. Yeah, tell me in the comments below if you guys can see any monk stuff, monk-related gear. Because that's no love for the monks. We have a couple arrows, but that's not enough, Trendy. That's not enough. Give us some more, like, bows and stuff. This is also really cool, this showcase, if you guys don't know what this is. But yeah. I guess that's it, guys. It's oNightPineberries. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like it. Thumbs up. It really helps me in the long run. If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, or anything you found in DD2 that I have not found yet, there's a lot of cool stuff. This is in Dungeon Defenders 1 as well, so I don't know where that's from. But yeah, there's a lot of really cool Easter eggs that I probably haven't found yet. If you guys have found any cool Easter eggs yourselves, please do tell me in the comments below, and I will definitely check it out, because those are fun to find. But yeah, that's all I can think of for now. Oh! If you guys have any questions, comments, concerns, please do tell me, and I will try to answer them as much as possible. I'm gonna do this really fast. Okay, so one. Okay, I think 5 is a max. Maybe. Let's try to be fast. Yeah, 5 is a max. I mean, we can probably. Never mind. Just be really fast. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching. So, oNightPineberries. Intro, outro, number 9. Peace.